For this video, we are going to do DC versus Marvel. Who's gonna win? So, first of all, I'm going to give these nails a background. I've obviously already created a gorgeous ballerina nail. You know it's my favourite style of nail at the minute. Bang on trend, that's what we like. So I'm using Bayside Kiss and Bubbles. First of all, I'm going to pop Bayside Kiss on the tip. I'm going to do this on all the nails. I'm just going to blend that back. This does not need to be perfect. This is just a background. A lot of this will be covered with the artwork. All the artwork is pretty much going to be done with paint, so acrylic paints. Pop that into the lamp for me, thank you. Give me your other hand. Second coat of colour. Then just pull it back with a gel brush. So with the bubbles colour, nice neat cuticle, drag it down over the top a little bit. We're just doing a quick basic fade. The most important part is the cuticle of this at the minute, because don't forget it's going to be covered with a design, purely just so the background has a little bit of interest. Second coat of bubbles. So now I'm going to seal this with top and base. I am going to add some pigment onto this, so I need the top and base there so I can put the pigment on. I also need to seal the gel polish as well. That needs to be nice and sealed. So I'm going to take off the sticky layer with nothing but the cotton pad. Well, it's tissue pad, this one is, till I can hear it squeaking. So I'm going to do that on all 10 nails. So now I'm going to use the absolutely gorgeous hologram pigment. Oh my god, this stuff's amazing. So I'm just going to take some of it and rub it in a little bit. I'm just going to put it, I'm not going to put it perfectly in one area. Just adding it quite random, just so you'll see a little bit of it popping through the design. Go over with the brush to take off any excess. And what that'll do is any of that excess will just sit in other places as well. I want it really random like that, so we're not trying to get a full look, we just want a bit of random sparkle. Just to make it a little bit more girly. Now I'm going to seal this hologram pigment. I'm going to seal it with top and base. I'm just going to use some gel residue wipe off solution to take off sticky layer. So because I'm going to paint on top of this surface, I'm going to buff the top layer just so it's matte. And I find that that really helps me when I paint, because the paint really grabs onto the area. We're going to do Batman on the thumb, and I'm just going to map out where I'm going to put Batman. Add the colour. So I'm going to add the black, obviously, to his Batman mask.
To cowl. The bat cowl.
The bat cowl?
Yeah.
Is that what it's called?
It's called the cowl, yeah. Cape and cowl.
Cape and cowl.
Yeah. I'm a teacher about superheroes now.
Is that like Simon Cowell?
No.
No. Batman, Batman, Batman. So I've got this flesh colour. This is a polycolour cord flesh tint. Where his skin is showing. Underneath his cowl. His cape falls over his traps. And he's got some serious traps going on. I've just watered that black down just so it's not so black. But notice how I did the lines first so they still show through. And the lines are obviously there for the ripples in the cape. I'm going to mix white with a tiniest bit of black to make a grey. That's going to go here. No way, did you see what I did there? Oh my god, look at that little bit there. I'm going to have to correct that. Take some of the black wash and just create a bit of depth into the shoulder there. I'm going to get this navy and make it into a wash. I'm just adding a little bit of it to parts of his cape. This is going to help you do the highlight. I'm just wiggling my brush just so it's more sketchy, so it looks more cartoony. I'm going to go down one side of his nose, then we're going to take white, a little bit of water, now with the black, just going to neaten them up a little bit. It's easier to put the eyes on and then neaten up around the outside. Going to give him a bit of a frame as well. With the black wash, just going to do a little bit of definition to his face. Now I'm going to take some black with just a little bit of water in so it's a bit more intense. And we're going to add some highlight now, using the white and some water. So a slight bit of highlight here on his cheek. And then we're going to highlight some of his, what's it called? Cowl. Some of his cowl. Now I'm going to take some black and we're going to do a bat sign here. So I've done the outline there, I'm just going to fill that in. So it's easier to do the outline than just fill it in, rather than trying to do the whole thing at once. If there's anything you don't like, you can take a tool and scratch off any paint. I think I'm happy with that now, so now I'm going to seal it. I'm going to seal it with top and base. Make sure all of the paint is completely dry. A look that's going to bring out that sparkle in the background as well. We're going to cure that now. So I'm going to take off the sticky layer with the gel residue wipe off solution. And there's Batman! Batman! Now we're going to do Wonder Woman. No, not me. Actual Wonder Woman. No, I said no, not me. Actual Wonder Woman. You know, the one from the DC comics. Okay, I need to sketch her out. So I'm literally just sketching out where I'm going to place Wonder Woman. Okay, so I'll sketch that a little bit. I'm going to start with the flesh colour. gold for her headband. I'm going to do another layer of the flesh colour. Prefer to layer it up than to just whack a whole load of paint on. Okay, we're going to put the features in. Black, about 50% water. And we can gently just add where the features are going to be. Just going to pop in her eyes now. Bit of shading and highlighting, it's all about the shading and highlighting. So I'm just doing a little bit of shading and highlighting on her headband. So the reason that I'm going to do blue first is because that's going to be the sort of mid-tone to the hair, and then we're going to add the black for the low lights of the hair, and then we'll add a lighter pale blue for the highlighted parts of the hair. Can you see how that's giving it a mid-tone to the hair, and now you've got the depth with the black? We're going to use that for the highlight. So, tiny, tiny, tiny strokes. Right, we're going to seal this in now. I'm happy with that. So we're going to cure that now. 2 seconds. Just going to wipe that sticky layer off. There's Wonder Woman! Now we're going to move on to Superman! So I'm going to do... a bit of sketching first with some watered down white paint. Superman! They've all got big traps, haven't they? They've all got big traps going on. Traps are this muscle here. And I know that lots of men love having big traps. So I'm just putting one thin coat of this colour on, and we can start to put the rest of the colour on, so like his suit on his traps. and his hair colour. So we need a bit of black. His hair is going to be black. It's going to have some white highlights. I'm literally going to do all the borders of his hair and then fill that in. Second layer of the flesh colour. It's going to make it more dense, make the pigment more opaque. So this is the first time that I've used flesh tint, because I didn't have it, and I have it now. So I used to have to mix one, whereas now I can just use it straight from the bottle. We've added a tiny bit of brown for Superman, but the other characters, I just used it straight from the bottle. It's a really good skin colour for doing any kind of portraits or anything like that. His cape that's just sneaking over his traps. Okay, now we can start to add detail. I'm making sure my brush is completely clean. A little bit of black. Wash it down with some water. I don't want it to be too pigmented. Just gonna outline his super manly jaw. Just adding a little bit of detail around his hair.
It's been flying around all day, it's a bit ruffled.
Yes, a bit ruffled there. Now I need to start putting the facial details in, which kind of scare me a little bit. Okay, so we have the eyebrows, the nose, the mouth. Now for the eyes, that are very close to the eyebrows. I'm just going to neaten these eyebrows up. I'm not going to make them like as neat as mine. I'm just going to neaten them up a little bit. So I'm going to do that by using the skin colour that we previously mixed. Now for a bit of shading and highlighting on the actual face. So I've taken burnt sienna, put quite a bit of water into it so you have a wash. So she's going to bring a little bit of warmth to his face and also cast a bit of shadow. Don't forget, when you're highlighting and shadowing, you need to think about where the light is coming from all the time. And make sure you pop it in the right place. So it's easier to do it on one side. So if you imagine the light's coming from this side, it's going to look more realistic then. Just got to highlight his hair. Tiny, tiny strokes, tiny amount of paint. It's going to give him some dark pupils now. Okay, so that's him finished. I'm going to seal it with top and base. So because we haven't got his logo, I'm going to put his logo onto the little nail and cure that into the lamp now. So I'm just going to wipe over that and take off the sticky layer. I can put a bit of oil onto this now. Now that one's finished. So these two nails haven't got no design on really. So I'm going to put Superman on here, and I'm going to put Wonder Woman. I'll put that logo on there. Instead of filling it all red and then going over with yellow, which would be harder to do, I'm going to fill it with yellow, and then I can do the rest of the design in the red over the top of the yellow, because that will be a lot easier. Because if you do red, the yellow over the top won't be intense enough, if that makes sense. I'm going to do two coats of this. So I don't want the blue showing through, because it'll change the colour of the yellow to green. While that's drying, I'm just going to give it a bit of a border. with some black. Don't worry about getting too close to the border because that part will be red. I've got some red. And I'm going around the outside of the yellow. Now we're going to do the S. We're going to break it down into sections. So we're going to start with the sort of end or beginning of the S. And then we're going to come round and do the first curve. Curving through the middle, start moving. Now we're going to add a border to it with some black paint. Water it down because you want it to run really nice and clean. You don't want any thick, lumpy paint. So we've got the Superman logo there. Sexy Superman logo. Gonna seal that with top and base from the Urban Graffiti range. Pop that into the lamp and then we can do the Wonder Woman logo.
Wonder Woman!
Wonder Woman time. I'm just scratching off anything that I don't want, which is the joys of having gel polish underneath. A little bit of water with it because we want it to run really nice and easy. I'm going to do the edges first. So you can see that mistake that I've just made there. I'll have to scratch that off after. So the W's, the two W's that we're going to do now, we're going to join them together. This is the scary bit. So I'm going to start in the middle. Start to map it out in the middle. And then we're going to come from this top wing. Round down and join to the bottom. Same again, this side. I'm just going to let that dry now. And then I can seal that in with top and base. I'm going to seal this in with top and base. It'll smooth it all out and it'll bring out the brightness of the colours as well. So I'm just going to wipe over with gel residue wipe off solution. Take off that sticky layer. And there's the Wonder Nail. I can finish that with some cuticle oil. Give that a rub all the way around. So in the next video, we are going to do Marvel. What's going on?